children, we would dream of Christmas morn and all the gifts and toys we knew we'd find. But we've never realized a baby born one blessed night gave us the greatest gift of our lives. We are the reason that he gave his life. We are the reason that he suffered then died. To a world that was lost, he gave all he could give to show us the reason to live. As the years went by, we learned more about gifts and giving of ourselves and what that means. On a dark and cloudy day, a man hung dying in the rain because of love. Oh, because of love. We are the reason gave his life. We are the reason that he suffered and died. To a world that was lost, he gave all he could give to show us the reason to live. I finally found the reason for living. It's in giving every part of my heart to him. In all that I do, every word that I say, I'll be giving my heart just for him, for him. We are the reason that he gave his life. Oh, we are the reason that he suffered and died. To a world that was lost, he gave all he could give to show us the reason to live. He is my reason to
the people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in a land of deep darkness, a light will shine. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. The government will rest on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His government and his peace will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of Heaven's armies will make this happen. Light the Advent candles. Light them. Trim the wicks. Watch the reflections. Sit in the dark and wait. Wait through the long black night. Wait through the black that gets in your marrow. Wait through the dying, the cries you can't hear, the lurching gasp of the last death heaves. Sit through the night and the losses that scrape the sides of a soul, the burning tears that run. Run through this night even now. Taste her saltiness and the darkness that seeps in cold at the corners and stains 1,000 souls all alone. Wait in the cosmic dark. Inhale the black of an endless universe. Stare into it and feel the darkness get darker. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great enveloping cosmic dark, wrote the American astronomer and astrophysicist Carl Sagan. That loneliness can envelop you in a loud room full of voices. When you stand at the window and watch the dusk thicken. When you turn out the last light. To cross even the vast blackness of the Milky Way alone would take 100,000 years traveling at the blurring speed of light. You can sit in the dark and feel the reverberating echo of Carl Sagan's words through our impossible emptiness, like a blaring headline for the world. In our obscurity, in all this vastness, there is no hint that help will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. That is what one of our wise men decreed to us, who are living, walking, dying in the darkness, that there's no hint that help will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. No hint of help, no rumor of relief, no sign of saving. For us, waiting through the night, waiting through the dark. And then, there it comes to the waiting, to the leaning, to the cold, a dawn, light, light. Not mere candles waving in the face of the black, but a dawn to pry up the dark with bright shards, to peel it back and flood the cold room with light, a light from beyond, erupting. A fire that the people walking in darkness did not set, but that they saw. A light that the people in the dark couldn't ignite, couldn't inflame, and couldn't fabricate, but could only find. Christmas can only be found. Christmas cannot be bought. Christmas cannot be created. Christmas cannot be made by hand, lit up, set out, dreamed up. Christmas can only be found. In the nursery, in the cradling trough, in the mire and in the stench, and in the unexpected, and only in the dawning of Christ. True, Mr. Sagan, there is no hint that help will come from somewhere else to save us. There is a dawn in the dark. There is unstoppable light. There is God, glory blazing. Our God who breathes stars in the dark. He breathes Bethlehem star, then takes on lungs, and breathes in stable air. We are saved from hopelessness because God came with infant fists and opened wide his hand to take the iron-sharp edge of our sins. Our God who formed and delivered the black of the heavens, he waits patient like an embryo in a womb and delivers himself to free you. We are saved from forever pain because God pierced the dark and came to the pinpoint of us in the universe and took the nails. Our God who cradles whole inking galaxies in the palm of his hand, whom highest heavens cannot contain, he folds himself into our skin and he uncurls his newborn fingers in the cradle of a barn feeding trough, and we are saved from ourselves. We are saved from our loneliness because God is love and he cannot stand to leave us by ourselves. To ourselves. That is the message of Christmas. The message of Christmas is not that we can make peace, or that we can make love, make light, make gifts, or make this world save itself. The message of Christmas is that this world's a mess, and we can never save ourselves from ourselves, and we need a Messiah. For unto us a child is born. The light never comes how you expect it. It comes as the unlikely and unexpected, straight into Bethlehem, unlikely, and the feed trough, hopeless. And Christmas whispers, there is always hope. It doesn't matter how dark the dark is, a light can still dawn. It doesn't matter if the world whispers, there's not a hint that help will come from elsewhere, telling us that nothing will ever improve, get better, change. God favors the darkest places, so you can see his light the brightest. And once the light of Christ shatters your dark, shadows forever flee your shadowlands. There's no going back and living in the dark. You live in the impenetrable safe light of light. And Christmas never ends for you. A Christian never stops living Christmas. True, you cannot light Christmas because it's Christmas that lights you. It's Christmas that dawns on you. And you only really believe in Christmas when you really live it. When you light a dark world in the unexpected places with a brave flame of joy. When you warm the cold, hopeless places with the daring joy that God is with us, God is for us, God is in us, and you are a wick to light hope in the dark, then you believe in Christmas. When you really believe in Christmas, you believe there really is hope for everyone. When you get Christmas, people get hope from you. They don't lose it. Unless you keep passing on the miracle of hope, you live like Christmas is a myth. So light the Advent candles. Light them. And you can see it. With every lit candle, sparks of the dawning. Hope catching on everything. Bring someone a candle today and light it for him or her. Tell the person that you pray the light of Christ may warm his or her heart today. Fear not. Don't hide his light under a bushel. Late on a sleepy, star-spangled night, those angels peeled back the sky just like you would tear open a sparkling Christmas present. Then with light and joy pouring out of heaven, like water through a broken dam, they began to shout and sing the message that baby Jesus had been born. The world had a savior. The angels called it good news, and it was. In what areas of your life do you need Christ's light to dawn? Has your hope dimmed or flickered out somewhere along the way? Would you dare to ask God to reignite your hope again? What is one thing you can do to spark hope for someone else today?